You've probably seen a bunch of people repost this paragraph on Instagram. I saw it on my feed a few times over the last few days actually. But before you go and post that screenshot, you're gonna wanna hear what I have to say. Welcome back to Inform Overload, where we do the news and we make it entertaining. I'm Ron Burgundy. Subscribe for trending news updates and follow the IO team on Instagram and Twitter. My name's Charlotte, actually. Charlotte, not Ron Burgundy. If you're an Instagram user, you've probably seen this paragraph reposted on one of your friend's stories or physical Instagram feeds. The paragraph is quite long, so I'm not gonna go into detail about it, but basically what it says is, Instagram is changing its policy and somehow by reposting this paragraph to your Instagram, you block Facebook, Instagram's parent company, from using your private information, photos, and messages. The viral screenshot of a supposed change to Instagram's policies is actually almost a decade old and first went viral in 2012. I feel like I saw a lot of these things going around the internet in the early days of the web. You know, people would go on AIM and send a message that said, send this to 10 people or the boogeyman will lick your feet tonight. You reposted because like no one wants the boogeyman to lick your feet, but nothing was gonna happen if you didn't repost it. Honestly, I'm surprised that these things even go viral anymore. I fell for them when I was like 12 and I was legitimately afraid of the boogeyman. But this post went viral on Instagram just a few days ago thanks to several high profile celebrities like Julia Roberts, Pink Usher, and Governor Rick Perry of the US Department of Energy. Rick Perry. Well, according to Stephanie Otway, a spokesperson for Facebook, there is no truth to this post. You accomplish absolutely nothing by posting it, other than looking like an idiot. And it actually makes very little sense. It will not change Instagram's policy in any way. In fact, you agreed to let Instagram and Facebook use your content when you signed up for Instagram and Facebook. Okay? But it doesn't use your photos in a malicious way. They don't own your content and never claimed to own it. Instagram's policies grant it some uses of your photos and messages because it needs the permission to show it to other users. Without this permission, no one would see your posts and therefore, there's no point to even having social media without people seeing your posts. Social media implies interaction with other people other than yourself. According to Instagram's policies, they do not claim ownership of your content, but you grant them a license to use it. You can end this license at any time by deleting your content or your account entirely. The only other time when Instagram or Facebook could use your content is if law enforcement needs access to your account to help with a legal investigation. Even though it's been debunked as a hoax time and time again, people continue to repost this paragraph. What is the problem with a bunch of people posting a screenshot of a paragraph? Well, it shows exactly how quickly propaganda and false information can spread on the internet. And meanwhile, Instagram does nothing about it. So what can you learn from this? Not everything you see on the internet is factual. Surprise! In fact, headlines and memes are perpetuating the spread of misinformation. All this viral post proves is that Instagram is not acting quickly enough to combat the spread of misinformation, and also that people are stupid. I hereby prohibit Instagram from using my photos. No, this does nothing. All it takes is a bunch of highly followed accounts to post the same meme and boom, everybody thinks Instagram owns your content. The lesson here, be critical. Be a critical thinker. If you're not sure about a topic, there's this really cool thing that you should know about. It's called Google. Use the website Snopes.com as well. It's a fact checker website that's pretty accurate. Check to see what the news is saying about it and cross check facts. Tell me your thoughts on this one down there in the comments. For now, I'm gonna wrap up this video with some comment features from my video, Most Hated Influencer on Earth. Wants you to pay for her butt lift. Rochelle Fetter said, I absolutely love you, Charlotte. You make me smile and laugh every time. Brianna Rabideau says, you sound like you're wearing slippers. I am. I shuffle around. It's kind of funny. Lori Emmett said, so her mental health is her butt.
Yes. That's about right, yes.
That is it for me and thanks for watching. If you want to keep watching, you should check out this playlist over here. It's clickable, you can click on it. And if you enjoyed your time here, leave a like, subscribe, turn on notifications, and maybe I'll see you in a future IO video.